Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at FXBootcamp.com. Today is Friday, February 8th, 2013. As I speak, it's almost 9:30 a.m. New York time. That marks the U.S. equity market open. You're looking at a weekly chart for the British pound U.S. dollar currency pair, otherwise known as cable, by foreign exchange traders around the world. This chart shown on the Awanda MT4 trading platform. I've discussed in the past an uptrend support line defined by a series of higher lows in the weekly chart going back to early 2009, and you can see in the upper right-hand portion, or actually the middle right-hand portion of this chart, this week's low. Again, this is the weekly chart. This week's low, very close to, if not right at, that trend line. So we have been generally in a recovery mode on cable. That is more up than down on cable ever since that technical bounce at or near that uptrend support line going back again some 4 years. Let's take a closer look at more recent price action. In this case, on a four-hour chart. Yeah, what I want to emphasize on this four-hour chart is a couple things. Number one, I'm going to freeze this chart for a moment to activate my drawing tool. Number one, this spike here, the rise you see here, that's in response to comments made yesterday by incoming Bank of England Governor Mark Carney, whose comments to British lawmakers were interpreted as more hawkish than expected. Mark Carney actually made references to normalizing policy in some way, shape, or form. So the British pound rose. Again, part of it could have been a technical move. Part of it could have been maybe some short covering the British pound. You see the pound rose just earlier today. More green on the British pound there. Again, maybe possibly some short covering more than anything else. But that brings in play the possibility for maybe one more long on cable before the end of the trading week. This 57.60 zone has really been important in the past. Let me activate the drawing tool to show you some examples here. The post-Carney comments high on the on cable yesterday, near 57.60. You see the 57.60 zone represented by the horizontal blue line in the middle of this chart. Put a lid on cable there. It affected price action in late January there as well. So the plan for a cable bull is this: a long at or near 157.60, targeting perhaps 158.40. We've got a daily R2 pivot point just some 8 or 10 pips below that. The 58.40 zone has shown some history of affecting price action on this pair in the past. So again, a trade plan for the wannabe cable bulls: long somewhere near 57.60, targeting the daily R2 just below 58.40 or perhaps 58.40 itself. An extreme target if we get bullish price action and a sharp rise up to 58.40 very quickly.
30 seconds to the U.S. equity market open.
In late January, earlier this month, those highs around 58.70, 58.75.